गुड आफ्टरनून, गुड आफ्टरनून दी लास्ट क्लास आई डिस्कस अबाउट दी शीट रेजिस्टेंस एज वेल एज दी शीट कैपेसिटेंस. विल मूव फॉर दी फर्दर गेट कैपेसिटेंस इटसेल्फ, दैट इज स्क्वायर सीसी एंड कैलकुलेशन. The capacitance C equal to epsilon minus epsilon naught E divided by D. A is the cross section area, D is the thickness, epsilon naught is the permittivity of the free space, epsilon inverse INS is relative permittivity of the insulator. Silicon for silicon dioxide, the constant value is 4. These two are the constant parameters, epsilon naught, epsilon inverse. Varying parameters are the area and over the thickness D. Okay, these are the three different technologies. That is 5 micrometer, orbit 2 micrometer, orbit 1.2 micrometer technology. These are the predefined values, a typical area capacitance values of mass circuit. Okay. I think we have been going for the calculation of the standard unit of a capacitance, square CZ. It is defined as the gate to channel capacitance of the MOS transistor having the L equal to W equal to L, that is standard square shown in figure. Shown in figure is, the figure is just here the figure what we have drawn, the calculation of a sheet resistance MOS transistor. One is P diffusion with an a polysilicon. For this length is 2 lambda and width also 2 lambda. Polysilicon to diffusion, a standard size. In that the things called the that length and width are the equal. Length and width are the equal, that means the standard square as shown in this figure. The units denoted, the unit is denoted by the square CZ. This is the unit for the standard capacitance is square CZ. It may be calculated for the any mass process as follows. Already we know that for the 5 micrometer technology, standard area per standard square is 5 micrometer. 5 micrometer is equal to 25 micrometers. Okay. And capacitance value is 4 into 10 to the power of 4 minus 4 picofarad per micrometer square. For a standard value is this capacitance value into area per standard square, it is 25 micrometer square into 4 into 10 to the power of minus 4 picofarad per micrometer square. That micrometer square get cancelled. 25 into 400 into 10 to the power of minus 4, which is nothing but as a name, 0.01 picofarads. That is capacitance square CZ capacitance value for a mass device is, when we use a 5 micrometer technology, the value is 0.01 picofarads. Okay, just we have to remember these values. Then when we move for the process time, that is delay, in that delay we are going to use these things, that is 0.1 picofarads. Already we know that RS value, that is sheet resistance value for an NMOS device is 10 to the power of 4, or we can simply write it as an 10 kilo ohms. Is it not? We have derived that things. And this is an a capacitance, square CZ capacitance. For a delay, if you multiply these two RS with an a square CZ, then we can get an a transistor time tau. Continuation part will go for that. Next is, that is for an a 5 micrometer technology. Similarly, for 2 micrometer technology, the 2 micrometer technology, the area per standard square is 2 micrometers into 2 micrometers, which is 4 micrometers. The capacitance value is 8 into 10 to the power of minus 4, if you multiply by these two, you will get that this thing, that is 0.0032 picofarads when we use a 2 micrometer technology. And for 1.2 micrometer technology, that is 1.2 to 1.2, it is equal to 1.4 micrometer square. That is standard value. Standard capacitance value is 16 into the power of minus 4. If you multiply these two, you get an a value for the 0.0023 picofarads. Then we have a 5 micrometer technology. The delay time is 0.01 picofarads. Okay, that is delay transistor time tau. Capacitance value is 0.01 picofarads. When we the transistor sizes, length and widths are reduced. Technology that is 2 micrometers, then automatically the area is compressed, area is reduced automatically, that is directly proportional. Already we know that in the formula, previous formula, that capacitance C is directly proportional to area. If you increase the area, capacitance value also increases. To decrease the area, the capacitance value is decreases. When we increase the length and width, then automatically area also increases. As the area increases, capacitance value also increases. Okay, in a 5 micrometer technology, the length and width are more, the area occupied here is more. When for a 2 micrometer, the area occupied is less. When it is less, automatically the standard square CZ value also less. For 5 micrometer, 0.01 picofarads. For 2 micrometers, 0.0032 picofarad. For 1.2 micrometer mass circuit, it is 0.0023 picofarads. These three values are being used for the further calculation. That is 0.01 picofarad, 0.0032 picofarad and 0.0023 picofarad. These values are further used for the calculation of the tau transistor time delay. Okay, already we have undergone these calculation of capacitance when we a slab, a uniform slab with a width of 3 lambda and a length of the 20 lambda. Then a standard relative area is area length into width divided by standard gate area, which is 20 lambda is the length and width is 3 lambda, is converted into the standard gate area is 2 lambda into 2 lambda, that is 60 lambda divided by 4, which is equal to 15. That means the standard gate area is 2 lambda into 2 lambda. How many times it is more? It is 15 times are greater as compared to standard. That is a ratio. It is a relative area. How many times it is more? It is 15 times more than that of the standard gate area. 15 times more than of the standard gate area. Okay. If you consider this is as in a metal, this slab as in a metal, then the metal, consider the area in metal. Say first one, capacitance to substrate, that is relative value. Relative area is 15. Relative C value from the table is relative value of the, that is for the metal. Here we have to take two cases, metal to substrate, metal 1 to substrate, relative C value. From this table, metal 1 to substrate, the relative value is 0.0023 0.075 is the relative value when we use that slab as in a metal. Okay, that value 15 into 0.075. 0.075 is the relative value metal to substrate. 15 into this, which is equal to 1.125 square cc. When this is this slab, this is considered as a metal. It is a capacitance value. Capacitance that standard square cc value is 1.1. It contributes when you take a metal. Same slab, same thing. When we consider the same area as a polysilicon. If this is an polysilicon, polysilicon to capacity. Polysilicon capacitance to substrate. Polysilicon to substrate. For this, when we use a polysilicon to substrate, in the table, polysilicon to substrate, relative value is 0.1. Relative value is 0.1. Polysilicon to substrate, relative value is 0.1. You have to multiply 15 into 0.1, which is equal to 1.5 square cc. Similarly, if you consider it as an end diffusion capacitance to substrate, when we consider this slab as an end diffusion, the capacitance produced by this slab is 15 into 0.25. This 0.25 is from this table only. That is end diffusion. For this diffusion, the value is 0.25. For an end diffusion, 0.25. For a pre diffusion, it is multiplied by the relative value. This table is purely for the end diffusion. All these values have been given for the end diffusion. Similarly, this table is applicable. We have to multiply all the values with 2.5 times. Okay, it is 15 into 0.25, 0.25 from the table, that is square cc, which is equal to 3.75 square cc. Already, I think I have been in the previous class, I have started with this problem. Then, if you consider this one, here they are the different. In this case, calculate a area of capacitance values associated with structure more than one layer. Here they are the different. In the previous example, we have took only one layer. Either it can be metal or polysilicon or any diffusion. In the previous example, we took that slab. Either it can be metal or it may be the polysilicon or it may be diffusion. If you are combined, that means in this structure it has a metal, polysilicon as well as the end diffusion. For this, first we have to calculate a capacitance value, that is a ratio. The ratio is for a metal. Then we have to calculate a metal capacitance, then go for a polysilicon, then go for the transistor gate capacitance, that is end diffusion capacitance. First we'll go for a ratio for a metal. In the metal, the relative area is 100 lambda into 3 lambda, which is 300 lambda, divided by the standard gate area is 2 lambda into 2 lambda. For this, that is, let's see, the first we'll go for a ratio of the ratio for the metal. It is 100 lambda into 100 lambda into 3 lambda divided by standard area is 2 lambda by 2 lambda, which is equal to that is 300 divided by 4, which is equal to 75. Okay. Same, we have to calculate the metal capacitance. what is the capacitance produced by this entire area metal. For that metal capacitance Cm equal to, Cm is the metal capacitance. Metal capacitance is that ratio. Ratio is 75 multiplied by the standard value. Standard value under the metal. Already we know that. The previous example we took, no. For that it is the 0.075. Okay, which is equal to 5.625 square cc. Okay, similarly it is for the Cm. We have to find the capacitance value for the polysilicon. The polysilicon entire area is first here we have a 2 lambda, one more 2 lambda as well as 1 lambda and width of the 2 lambda. For that total area here 2 lambda, 2 lambda, 1 lambda plus one more here is one more polysilicon area is there. This also a polysilicon. For this polysilicon entire area is 4 lambda into 4 lambda. For a below 3 lambda, 3 lambda is because here we have a 2 lambda and one more lambda, 1 lambda. Here one place is there, no? This place is 1 lambda. Total area is 4 lambda into 4 lambda plus 3 lambda into 2 lambda. For polysilicon. Okay, it is ratio for the metal which is nothing but as 4 lambda into 4 lambda plus 3 lambda into 2 lambda divided by standard area is 2 lambda into 2 lambda which is equal to 16 plus 6 22 divided by 4 which is 5.5, which is equal to 5.5 square cc. Okay, same we have to find the Cp, polysilicon capacitance is, sorry it is not the square cc, that ratio is 5.5 only. Okay, first we have to find the polysilicon capacitance equal to this ratio that is 5.5. Relative value for the Cp is 0.01 from the table itself. Relative value is the values are in the bracket, which is equal to 0.055 square cc. Is the capacitance value of an polysilicon. Similarly, ratio of the N diffusion ratio of an n diffusion is, n diffusion is the, here they are the 2 lambda diffusion of the n diffusion. N diffusion is 2 lambda into 2 lambda itself. That is, the area is given for the n diffusion is 2 lambda into 2 lambda divided by 2 lambda into 2 lambda, which is equal to 1. That means CD is a diffusion capacitance. CD equal to 1 into for n diffusion it is 1, which is equal to 1 square CZ. The relative value is also 1 and this value is also 1. For that n diffusion relative value is 1 square CZ. Total capacitance CT equal to CM plus CP plus CD. Total capacitance of the metal, capacitance of polysilicon, capacitance of the diffusion, which is equal to 5.625.55 plus 1, which is equal to 7.2 square CZ. Total capacitance of the above structure is of 7.2 square CZ. Already I have told in the previous class one example. When we increase the width from the 3 lambda to 4 lambda, this problem they have given in the previous exam, they will give the relative values, these relative values of the metal, relative of value of the polysilicon, relative value of the diffusion. They will give this thing and as well as this diagram. You have to find out this CT, total capacitance. CT equal to CM plus CP plus CD, total value, that add this thing, 5.55 plus 1, which is equal to 7.2 square CZ. If you increase this from the value for the 3 lambda to 4 lambda, in the previous class itself I have explained this one. If you increase this from the 3 lambda to 4 lambda, in this case that means 100 will be length same, width has increased from 3 to 4, that is 400 divided by the 4, which is equal to, the ratio is 100. 100 into 0.075, which is equal to 7.5 square CZ. The capacitance afforded by metal is 7.5 plus of 0.55 plus 1, which is equal to 9.05 square CZ for a total capacitance. Okay, it is increased chaste emothundi from the 7.2, it is increased to 9.05 square CZ. Okay, it is about this problem. Any doubts in this? ఈ దాంట్లో ఏమైనా అర్థం కాకుంటే అడిగితే చెప్తాను. ఇట్ ఈస్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ది ఇంపార్టెంట్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఇన్ ది ఫర్ ది ఎగ్జామినేషన్ పాయింట్. దేర్ ఆర్ టూ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఇన్ ది, వన్ ఈస్ ఫర్ ది డిలే క్యాలిక్యులేషన్, సెకండ్ ఈస్ ది కెపాసిటీస్ క్యాలిక్యులేషన్, అండ్ త్రీ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఆర్ దేర్. వన్ ఈస్ ఫర్ ది mass and CMOS sheet resistance calculation, second is capacitance calculation, third is the delay calculation. Okay, next we'll move for the delay. The overall thing called the purely what we studied about these two concepts, one is called RS sheet resistance, second is square Cz. Now standard capacitance square Cz. These things are used for the delay. Delay can be calculated using the concept of the sheet resistance. Delay can be calculated. The delay, device delay, can be calculated by using the concept called sheet resistance RS and standard unit capacitance square Cz. Can be used to calculate the. If we consider that a one square polysilicon, one square means 2 lambda into 2 lambda, is charged by a one square. One feature size diffusion, then the delay is, that is the capacitance is one feature size, that polysilicon is one feature size and diffusion is, that means simply if you say, if you take as an a 2 lambda into 2 lambda, the standard size is 2 lambda into 2 lambda, length is 2 lambda, width is 2 lambda for the polysilicon as well as the diffusion. Then the delay is nothing but a time constant tau equal to RS, either it can be P channel or N channel, into 1 square Cz, the time constant, time is measured in seconds, RS into Cz, say simply RS into square Cz. This can be evaluated for a technology. That technology is 5 micrometers, 2 micrometers, 1.2 micrometers. First we'll go for the calculation of a 5 micrometers, then 1.2 micrometers, then 1.2 micrometers. Okay. Then the value of a square Cz will be vary with a different technology. Okay. Value, the Cz will be constant. That RS is constant. Sheet resistance is constant. If you increase the length or width, that if you increase for a 5 micrometer technology or 2 micrometer technology and 1.2 micrometer technology, the sheet resistance is constant, but the square Cz value will be differ from technology to the technology because of variation in the minimum feature size. First we'll go for a 5 micrometer technology. In the 5 micrometer technology, using GaN diffusion, for that at delay time equal to tau RS into square Cz. Already we know that the transist time, delay time, tau equal to RS, the sheet resistance, into capacitance square, one square Cz capacitance, which is equal to, for a 5 micrometer technology, already you know that for an N diffusion, sheet resistance is 10 kilo ohms, that is 10 to the power of 4, multiplied by 0.01 picofarad. Already previously I have told that you need to remember these values when we calculate the delay in Japan. Okay, it is from the, this value is we got from the, 0.01 ekkada untochindi 5 micrometers into 5 micrometers, it is area per standard gate area, na 5 micrometers, which is equal to 25 micrometers square, is area, and that a relative value, C value is 0.25 relative value, which is 0.25 area, 1 minute. Is 0.25 into 4 into 10 to the power of 4 minus 4 picofarads, minus 4 picofarad per micrometer square, that is the value is 4 into that minute, that C's capacity, relative capacity value is 4 into the power of minus 4 into picofarad per micrometer, which is equal to 0.1 picofarads. This is a standard for a 5 micrometer technology. 5 micrometer is a value. Okay, here the capacitance value is 4 into 10 to the power of minus 4 picofarads per micrometer square. Why they are converted? Because the area is the micrometer square. For that reason, they have converted in terms of the micrometer square values itself. Okay, micrometer get cancelled. 425 into 4 is 1 10 to the power of minus 4, that is pico, which is nothing but as an A. That value is picofarads, that is 0.0100 into 10 to the power of minus 4, which is equal to 100 into 10 to the power of minus 4 picofarads. We can write this as a 0.01 picofarads. This capacitance value for a 5 micrometer technology. Okay. Similarly, this is equal to 10 to the power of 4 into 0.01 picofarad, which is equal to 0.1 nanoseconds. Okay, isn't it delay? Here they have wrote something called safe delay. It is 2 to 3 times greater than this one. Isn't it? 2 to 3 times this multiplication of 2 to 3, that is 0.2. Safe is 0.022 picofarads to the 0.03 picofarads. The value is increased. A delay value is increased due to two parameters. One is called wiring, second is called parasitic capacitance. Okay, parasitic elements. Okay, these two things influence the delay increases. That is, a safe delay is 0.03 nanoseconds for a 5 micrometer technology. Similarly, for 2 micrometer technology, the value is 0.064. It is, this value is from the previous one only calculation only, that is 2 micrometers into 2 micrometers divided by, that is 4 micrometer square. We have calculated that things. 0.032 picofarads, 0.0023 for the 1.2 micrometer technology. These are the values. Just observe the values from the delay point of view. What we need to understand, as we increase the technology, that is from the 5 micrometers to 2 micrometers, delay is decreases from the 1 to 0.64, from 0.64 to 0.46. And a delay decrease out there, and the transition time, switching time increase out there. The thing, basic thing is called, when we have a 2 micrometer technology, in that 2 micrometer technology, 0.064. In 1.2 micrometer technology, 0.46 nanoseconds. Okay. The safe figures are 0.202 and 0.01 nanoseconds. Okay. This about the next class lo ide continue chestanu. This concept only, the entire thing called the delay operation itself. For a 5 micrometer, and why this is safe, and it is delay in tau and etla, it is related to the transition time tau L square divided by mu n into VDS. Already we have derived in the current equation, VDS, IDS versus VDS, and equation lo derive chesyamu. Then it will be used. Okay, for a 5 micrometer length and width are same, that is 5 micrometers, mu n is the mobility charge carriers, VDS is in a voltage drain to source. Okay, idi next class cheptam, then cheppi further continuation is inverter delay, that is CMOS inverter, rise time, fall time. next class no we may take two more class for the this topic. Further, if you have any problems, anything, you can ask. Okay. Just wait for 2 more minutes. We will come the attendees. So one day strength is good, one day strength is being. The reason why I'm today is 31. Why are you reason? Is there any problems? Any doubts you can ask. Almost in this topic, almost sheet resistance, sheet capacitance, 5 chapter, 2 to 3 chapter.